from the start today, and the equity markets have taken the FTSE 100 to within a few points of the near six-week highs. Last week, the equity markets overall scored their best week since January, as the new Bank of England governor gave an indication of his thoughts on the UK monetary policy side. Among the small-cap movers at the start today, their medtech company Anglo added another chapter to its exciting story after successful testing of its breakthrough Parsortix technology that sifts out cancer cells from the blood. Researchers at the University of Surrey successfully used the system to screen for colorectal cancer. Of the 20 people tested, 75% were found positive for CTCs. Joining Anglo are shares in Aminex and Solo Oil, which have been awarded an appraisal license for their jointly owned Entoria 1 gas discovery in Tanzania. Granted for a period of 2 years, the license allows the pair to embark on a further seismic survey to assess the extent of the discovery. They're also allowed to sink an appraisal well. A lower gold price hitting commodities today overall has threatened the livelihoods of a number of gold companies on AIM. Mwana Africa today admitted that the falling gold price has led it to weigh up several funding options, including an equity placing. The Pan-African miner has been tightening its belt lately in response to the tough climate for miners as it aims to save up to $5 million a year. And Philippines-focused Medusa Mining, another battling with the fall in the gold price, watched its shares drop below £1 each. It cut its production estimates after narrower than expected gold veins at the Ko-O mine. Anticipated production for the June quarter will now be around 15,600 ounces of gold, and for the year to June, overall about 62,200 ounces. Meanwhile, a Zari miner, Anglo Asian Mining, thinks selling its copper concentrate will help lower its cash cost to around $450 an ounce of gold. The AIM-listed company is primarily a gold producer at the Gadabek mine in Azerbaijan, but also produces a copper concentrate. Today it unveiled a new copper sales agreement with Seagate Minerals and Metals. And Amur Minerals shares fell despite getting the green light from the Anti-Monopoly Board for a mining license for its Kunmaniye nickel project in Far East Russia. Representatives of the Russian state authorities have verbally confirmed that the Anti-Monopoly Board had approved the updated mining application. Let's look at some of the stocks on the move on Monday.